Hey there, thanks so much for joining me today. In the center ring, we have Luminar Neo and Skylum's new retouching program, Aperty. Which is the right program for you? Well, if you mostly photograph still lifes, products, real estate, landscapes, it's an easy choice. Get Luminar Neo and use my links below and the discount code Tom Cheswick to save an extra 10%, and you are on your way to having a great program. But if you specialize in portraits or weddings or anything people related, the choice isn't so clear because they both have advantages. Let's just take a look at this image. And right now we are in Luminar Neo, and we'll switch over to Aperty, and you'll see the results are very similar. Both programs doing a very nice job. But right now we're dealing with somebody who has very nice skin complexion. It's a very basic retouch edit. Let's take a look at some areas where Aperty excels and some where Neo excels. So for skin retouching, you are not going to beat the results you get for Aperty. So let's take a look at Neo first. Here's somebody who has really nice skin, but there are a few blemishes and a little bit of shine. And if we go into skin retouching and use the full amount and even remove shine and check the box for skin defects, it makes a nice improvement. But there are still areas up here that would need to be addressed, and also here on her cheek. If we look at the same image in Aperty and go into the retouching module there, I have blemish removal set to 77 and skin softening a little less than halfway, and we just get exceptional results. And again, this is a person who has really nice skin to begin with. If we go into a real challenging situation, we'll see that Aperty did a really nice job. Skin smoothing still not all the way up, blemish removal still not all the way up, but we're going from here to here. And this is where Aperty just blows away Luminar Neo. So if you're a portrait photographer who photographs lots of seniors or headshots or things where you are doing lots of retouching, the choice is going to be easy for you too. You're going to want to get Aperty using my link below and the discount code Tom Cheswick to save 10%. Right, if we take that image in Neo, it just doesn't have a chance to do anything for this image. Even if we crank the amounts up to 100% and use skin defects removal, there's still so much manual retouching to do. And that's going to take a lot of time. It definitely can be done. So if you're doing just a few portraits, Neo does have the tools, the erase and the clone tools, so you could definitely achieve a nice retouch, but it is going to take a lot of time. Where Aperty, it was very quick, and then we could copy those settings and apply it to the next 30 or 50 images that we took of her and have all the retouching automatically done. Aperty also gives you slightly better masking. So let's take a look at this image in Luminar Neo. And all I did was change the color of the background using the masking tools within Neo. You can see it didn't quite capture the area in between her blonde hair. That is fairly difficult masking, but there's no refinement brush to really be able to achieve excellent results. Let's take a look at this image in Aperty. So as we can see, much better results on that side of the hair and on her right side as well. So definitely an improvement. but neither program is excellent at masking. If we take a look at the inside section between her body and arm, only half of it was masked correctly, the other part isn't. And we also have the same problem with her right arm, where it's not masked very well. And the masking of Luminar Neo actually gave us very similar results. Both programs could really use a brush to refine mask. There are other programs that may not get you the perfect mask right away, but they do offer refinement tools to really be able to improve the mask. So to be able to get that area in between her hair, to quickly be able to get this area here. Hopefully Neo and Aperty come up with a tool to refine their mask. So again, Aperty excels at retouching. But what are the advantages for a portrait photographer with Luminar Neo? Well, three things come to mind. The first one, probably not that big of a deal, but it's something I really like. Right now, they both have the film strip mode. This is new for Luminar Neo. It will be released in the fall edition. I'm using a beta version of both programs, so if you don't have the film strip yet, you will once the fall edition is released. But one look that Neo has in their catalog is the grid mode. And now it actually has a new filter section as well. Let me just reset that. But I find it so quick and easy to be able to go through the grid mode and quickly go back to either the beginning of a shoot or quickly get down to the end or whatever section I'm looking for. But it's just a quick way to look through hundreds of images, and that's a lot more time consuming for me when I'm just looking at the film strip mode. So not a huge advantage, but an advantage. So I'm going to sort it again by ratings. Ratings are new to the fall edition as well, and also you can sort by quite a few different ways, by cameras, by ISOs, all sorts of things that you're just going to love. But I'm just going to select the favorites right now. So with Aperty, you can pick your favorites or reject the ones. And when you sort the film strip, you can select picks by that way. So you can have all your picks together as well. You just can't hide everything else. Then the other two advantages of Neo. First is textures and being able to swap backgrounds. And for a portrait photographer, this is huge. Aperty needs to add this functionality to its program. So with this image of Kastle, the original capture was like this. And using a technique that Joel Grimes has made super popular, is adding texture to a simple gray background to get something like this. And you can't do this in Aperty. And that's a huge problem because portrait photographers swap out backgrounds. We either add texture or we change the background completely to have a totally different look. Right, so being able to do something like this is probably the ideal background for this image, but just to give you a quick look, I mean, that is something portrait photographers do. And you can see it's relatively quick in Neo. There are other programs that make it even easier to be able to swap a background, but you can get the job done in Neo. Aperty has no ability that I can see to add a different background. If I'm wrong, correct me in the comments below. I'd love to be able to do this in Aperty, whether it's changing a background or adding textures to the background. This is something I do often with my images. The last advantage that Luminar Neo has, Is there gen erase, gen swap, and gen expand? And each of these has been updated with the new fall release of Luminar Neo. So take this example of Lydia, where I went way off the background and had my backlights in the image. And just to quickly show you with Gen Erase, this was last year's version, and you can see some of the wings got cut off. It did a pretty decent job, but the new Gen Erase is even better. So as you can see, both programs are excellent. Aperty is definitely the one to get if skin retouching is your main priority. But Neo does have some advantages as well, especially with their Gen Erase, Gen Swap, and Gen Expand tools, and being able to add textures or swap backgrounds. I find both programs valuable for my portraiture. I wish I could pick just one, but I definitely need the retouching abilities of Aperty for my portraits, and I really need to be able to swap backgrounds and add textures, so I need Neo for that as well. So whichever program's best for you, be sure to use my links below and use Tom Cheswick as a discount code to save an additional 10%. Be sure to give the video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. If you have any questions or comments, be sure to leave those down below. And be sure to subscribe so you're notified when my next video is released. Until next time, keep shooting!